Hey, this is DJ from DJ's Trains on YouTube, and what you are looking at is Demler Yard. And I hope you get a good look at it because you're not going to see it in person. This is one of those places that I work that is not really accessible to the public. So I wanted to show you what it looks like, but more importantly, I'm going to show you a lot of stuff to help you improve your modeling. So here we go. Before we take a closer look at Demler Yard, we're going to take another look at Riverton Yard, which I covered in a previous video. The yards are attached to each other. And here you see some of our yard engines. And behind it is a westbound mainline freight train. But more importantly, we're going to stop the video right about here. Because when I posted a previous video, people said, hey, what is that black drop cloth where the engines are? So, I took the camera, and we're going to take a closer look for you. On tracks that we store our engines is where you can find the drop cloths. Now, the drop cloths have one function, and that is to protect the ground from any fluids that might be dripping from the engine, whether it's fuel or oil or just any fluids. This protects the ground. You may also see sand on it occasionally, because our engines do use sand. We do have sanders that provide additional traction, and sometimes those sanders can come on unintentionally, and that's why you will see sand sometimes here also. The unsung heroes of the railroad are the maintenance of way people, that's the MOW, and the mechanical forces. If it wasn't for them, we would not have a safe railroad. So let's look at the MOW and how you'll see them in the yard. It's very common to see flat cars with our maintenance equipment on it. Here I caught a ditcher on a flat car, and it is next to a side dump car. These side dump cars are pretty neat. You can put pretty much anything in it, and then you find a place where you can safely dump your stuff and then go back and refill. And so you will see a ditcher normally next to a side dump car. Here's a pretty cool close-up of them. These cars take a beating, so if you buy a model one, make sure you beat it and weather it. Here's something neat to model. A lot of our maintenance of way equipment was painted orange. Hey, and at one time we did have a few engines that were painted orange, and they were assigned to the MOW trains. The mechanical department in a yard handles a lot of car repairs, such as changing drawbars and knuckles, brake pads. They help sometimes with brakes if we have like a stuck handbrake. And even they'll do wheel changes. And so here's something cool to model, just a couple small tracks where we have replacement wheels. Another neat thing you're going to find in Riverton Yard on occasion is our cabooses, also known now as shoving platforms. We have a couple bay window cabooses, and they have one job, and that is just to protect the conductor on a shove movement. There are a few little industries that we have to go to on locals and on yard jobs, and when we have to shove to that direction because of a facing point switch, if there's not a safe place for the conductor to ride on that last car, then he will jump inside one of these cabooses and go for a ride. They're not glamorous anymore. I know you used to think they were so glamorous, but no, this is basically just, it is what it is on this one. It's just a shoving platform. A lot of the cabooses now have the doors closed and welded shut, so you can't even go inside. But this is just a place for the conductor to stand as he watches the shove movement to the industry. To simplify this video, I'm just going to tell you this is the east end of the yard. I will not be able to show you the west end of the yard. But it basically looks like this. Every track is double-sided, which means there is a switch on each end, with the exception of number 6 track, where you can, if you look closely, you can see some maintenance equipment stored there. Now, the tracks used to be closer together. to the point where when there was so much rocking that cars would sideswipe against each other. It could bust off our side view mirrors on our yard engines. So we took out the number 5 track and we moved every track over just a few inches to allow for more clearance. But instead of going through all the details of this yard and what it does, I'm going to show you some things that you can model and explain another important aspect of the yard. On both ends of Demler Yard, you're going to find ground air. There's going to be an air compressor building nearby, and it's going to send 80 pounds of pressure of air through an underground system. And then when it gets to the tracks, the pipes come above ground, and we can turn on and off each individual hose. From here, 80 pounds of pressure will come through these hoses, and we connect that onto the car's braking system to charge up the train's air brakes. When the train is charged, the car inspectors can do their walking inspection. And it also, we keep these cars charged for whenever the freight trains come by and do their pickups. So you see the hose. Each rail car does have a hose on each end, and they must be connected together to allow the air to go all the way through the train to charge the braking system. Now, you can model ground line simply with wire or with string, but this will be a nice little realistic touch in your yard. The ground line is found at the clearance points, which is always shown with the yellow tie. This is one of our air compressor buildings, and this can be easily scratch built. It'll be a nice little detail for your yard. And speaking of air, we now have an air-conditioned shed for the conductors to cool off on those hot summer days when the sun's beating on them and they need to take a quick break. And no yard would be complete without some old abandoned buildings or yard offices. I don't even know what this was, but I'm not going in it to find out. And make sure that you have enough spilled product in your yard tracks to show that cars have been sitting for a while. Nothing's perfect in the real world, so make it not perfect on your layout. Well, after filming in the yard, I caught this beautiful sunset that night, and I just wanted to share it with you. Another reason why I filmed that video is so that you don't feel the need to trespass or to come onto the property to try to learn things on your own. I'll teach you everything I can, everything that I know, this way that you don't have to try to find out the hard way by coming onto our property. So if you have any questions, ideas, suggestions, you can follow me on Facebook or Twitter or Instagram. Everything's under DJ's Trains. If you think that my videos have helped you with your modeling or just general knowledge of the railroad and you want to support the channel, you can please do so through my PayPal. I really appreciate it. Every bit helps right now. So thank you guys so much. I got so much more footage coming. I got a lot of great videos. So thanks for watching. Check out this sunset. It's ridiculous.